And today we're going to make a pocket square. Pocket squares are so simple to make and they take such a small amount of fabric that you're going to want to take all of your scraps and make them into pocket squares. These also make great gifts. The supplies for this project are very simple. We're going to need matching thread, you're going to need a pair of scissors, your chalk, and I'm going to be using an L square, but you could use any sort of ruler. I bet you're wondering, how much fabric do you need to make a pocket square? Pocket squares range from 10 to 17 inches square. I'm going to be making my pocket square 12 by 12 finished, which means I need at least 13 by 13 inches of fabric. The first thing we're gonna need to do is trace out a square on our fabric for the pattern of a pocket square. I'm going to be making mine 12 by 12 inches, and it's gonna have a half inch seam allowance all the way around, which means my square is going to be 13 by 13 inches. You can use any ruler for this, but I'm going to be using an L square to make sure that my square does not turn out lopsided. The first thing you wanna do is place your L square with the long side of the ruler along the lengthwise grain of the fabric, which is running all the way down your fabric. If you need help finding out where your grain lines are at on your fabric, check out my video that's all about grain lines and where they're at on your fabric. The first thing we're gonna do after we have our ruler placed is go ahead and chalk a line. And once you get to the corner, come up the other side of the ruler. Now I want you to put a mark right where the 13 is so we know where to place our ruler next. This fabric likes to move around, so just hold it still. So now we have our mark at 13. Now I want you to take your L square and we're gonna make another square corner. Now you're gonna place your L square along the line you just made and you want the corner to line up with that mark you just made on your fabric. Now this is gonna give us a square corner going all the way to the other end of our pocket square. Now, let's chalk the line. Check out our awesome square corner. Now we're gonna measure down from this corner 13 inches and put a mark. And we're gonna repeat the exact same process we just went through to get a nice square corner. I have the ruler lined up with my previous line I just chalked. And now, when I come down here to the 13 mark, I can chalk right down the last side of our square. And when I lift this square up, we should have a square under our L square. Check it out. We now have a square drawn on our fabric. Now grab your scissors and let's go ahead and cut this square out. Here we go! We now have our square cut out for our pocket square. All that's left is roll hemming the edges. Now let's go over to the sewing machine and hem those edges. Today I'm gonna be using the Husqvarna Viking Designer Epic. It's one of my favorite sewing machines right now. What's your favorite sewing machine to sew on? Before we start sewing, make sure that your machine is set up with a straight stitch for a lightweight fabric. We wanna do a little rolled hem on here, so I'm gonna fold it a quarter and another quarter inch, and then we're gonna end up sewing right on the edge here for a little edge stitch. If it's easier for you, you can go over to the iron and iron it up a quarter and flip it and iron it down another quarter. I'm just gonna roll it as I sew it with my hands. I'm not going to backstitch because I'm gonna be rolling this other edge and I don't want those extra stitches in there. So just go ahead and cut your thread. Here, you do want to backstitch or use the fix. If it wants to get stuck on the corner, pull your back thread tail. And make sure you do the same thing for every corner. We did it! We sewed up a pocket square. Look how nice the edges look. Now, it's time to give it to your boyfriend, or give it away as a gift, or simply wear it yourself. Thanks so much for watching Sew Anastasia today. If you're in Chicago, make sure you check out my sewing classes and come visit me in the design studio. And if you're not, make sure you stay up to date with me on Instagram. I'm at Sew Anastasia or Anastasia Chatzka. And most importantly, don't forget to hit that notification button so you can see all my other awesome videos. I have a new video come out every week. Thanks for watching. Bye.